see AgTech as a quite broad definition. Some call it agri-food tech, some call it AgTech, and I do think it spans the whole food and fiber value chain. So from new ways to get inputs or distribution to farmers, on-farm technologies, supply chain technologies, all the way into sort of food and even how we as consumers get food and how we interact with it in our homes and our kitchens. So really innovation along the whole value chain.
What's your assessment of the current status of ag tech in Australia?
I'm really optimistic and positive about it. I would say 2 years ago, it was aspirational and ambitious, but wasn't really there yet. Not that farmers weren't innovative or researchers weren't doing technology and precision ag didn't exist, but there wasn't a innovation ecosystem for startups and entrepreneurs backed by venture capital, which I think is the lifeblood of this new revolution. And that exists now. We have 7 or 8 accelerators. We have a number of startups that are competitive globally. We're attracting funding from traditional venture capitalists and offshore venture capitalists. So not that it's all about the money or the funding, but that is a good metric for how much of an ecosystem we've already built and how vibrant it's becoming.
Now, your company, AgThentic, what do you do? What part are you playing?
At AgThentic, we look to connect ag and ag tech. That's kind of the high level picture. Make sure that the technologies being developed actually solve real problems and that the users and the people with those problems are connected to those technologies and well suited to adopt them and understand them and get value from them. So we do a lot of work around those kind of two sides. We also have a growth advisory business. So we work directly with startups in a really hands-on operational executional way to help them grow and scale and achieve their objectives, as well as sort of strategy consulting on the more ecosystem and strategic level. I asked, you know, who kind of agrees that we have a global competitive advantage in agriculture, and not surprisingly, everyone does agree. You know, clean, green reputation and proximity to Asia, and all of this emits tough soils and low subsidies. But what does that mean for ag tech? Do we actually have a global competitive advantage in ag tech? And I think there was a bit of skepticism in the audience. Hopefully, the consensus here today is that we can. And I think that's really true. Australia can have a global competitive advantage in ag tech. We might not be there yet, but we're well on our way.
I was going to ask, what do you see for ag tech in 10 years' time? But that's probably too long a time frame. What about 5 years?
I hope that Australia continues to hone in on competitive advantages of Australia instead of trying to be things that we're not going to be here. So trying to be like Silicon Valley or like Israel. What do we have here that are competitive advantages? So one, I think, is just the strength and innovativeness of our farming sector, of farming industry. So how do we bring more producers into the innovation world and into the innovation ecosystem? So producer-led innovation is something I'm really excited about. Similarly, we have lots of knowledge and networks and know-how in our research organizations. And so I think in 5 years, I really want to see more engagement between the research and farming, agriculture, and technology communities really working together.
Sarah Nolet, thanks so much for joining us on The Anvil.
Thank you.